You should definitely speak two languages, partly because speaking another language makes you think more rationally, but also because sexy accents make me totally irrational. Hola, everyone. I'm Julian, and willkommen, bienvenue, welcome to D News. Before we start, I want to pose to you a question. Let's say I give you $15 and then start flipping a coin. Let's say that you had a choice to bet a dollar each time, and if you win, you get $1.50, but if you lose, I take your dollar. How often do you bet? Now, it seems straightforward, but your answer probably depends on where you're from. More specifically, it probably depends on whether or not I asked you that question in your native language. The science says if you speak English, you probably bet about 54% of the time. But I know there's a lot of you from outside the US because I get a lot of angry comments every time I use the imperial system. And if you're from a non-English speaking country, you probably bet about 72% of the time. Well, you're gonna hate this, my fellow Americans, but betting every time is the right choice. Statistically speaking, you're almost definitely going to be making money in the long term. So, why did native English speakers pick wrong more often? Well, the current hypothesis is having to think in a foreign language requires more cognitive power, and by having to think it through more thoroughly, you're more likely to make a rational decision. The experiment was first done by researchers from the University of Chicago in 2012. It took place on three different continents, and participants were English speakers who had learned Japanese, French, or Spanish, and Koreans who had learned English. So it's not like it's just an English speakers who declined to bet more or anything like that. It really does depend if you're asked to bet in your mother tongue. The researchers extrapolated this information to more common scenarios. One researcher, Albert Costa, mused that maybe this is why people switch to their native language in a heated argument, and maybe that's also why they tend to say more hurtful things they're going to regret after the switch. The researchers also didn't believe that the cognitive improvement is lessened with proficiency, noting that when people understood complex nuances of languages like idioms, taboo words, and expressions of love, they still react less emotionally. This just adds another reason to the long, long list of why being bilingual is awesome. And yes, the delayed onset of Alzheimer's is rad, and being able to survive in foreign lands is cool, but I'm telling you, dude, chicks dig accents. So, does being bilingual make you smarter, or does being smarter make you better at languages? Well, Trace and a guest, Alice, have the answer to that over here. And did you bet when I posed you that question? Or have you learned a second language and noticed a difference in how you think? I'm always interested in hearing about stuff like this because I grew up in America and I'm just now getting the hang of speaking the English talk. So let us know in the comments, and I'll see you next time on D News.